Hi fellow viewers, to everybody, my name is Steve. The next necrological video that I will present is about Filipino catechism. She's the a big trending in not only in social media but also in the Catholic community in the Philippines. By the way, I'm referring to Lauriana Franco. She is known as called Ka Loring Franco or Ka Loring. Of all Filipino Catholic community, they are referring as the first female saint in the Philippines, because there was two saints canonized and beatified by the Vatican or the Pope. Before we had a saint called or named, first is Lorenzo Ruiz, that is the first saint. Then second from Cebu, these two already died. His name is Pedro Calunsod. So that's how we confirm. This one, if the Vatican will allow beatified and canonized, because she was under Diocese of Pasig. Her name is Lauriana Franco. Who is Lauriana Franco? Okay. Lauriana Franco is a Filipina catechist and a member of Legion of Mary who devoted her life to serving her local diocese and its poor. She's the eldest of 8 children, meaning all of them, they are 8 siblings. So that's it. Based on her profile as a necrological practitioner, she was working in Philippine airports as telephone switchboard operator and accounting clerk. Although she resigned in 1969 and she attended full-time to practice catechism, meaning to serve the poor as a Catholic servant. So that's it. Based on my other findings, she received two separate years of award. First is in last April 1, 1990, she was awarded from Pope John Paul II as Pro Ecclesia et Pontifice for her exemplary as a lay catechist. And another one is no specific day, although a year in 2002, she received a Mother Teresa Award, which is a project of AY Foundation Incorporated and the Manila Jaycees for her work with the poor and needy for the less fortunate. She spent much of her life as a catechist in the Philippines. She is regarded as a saintly and faithful woman who turned down a well-paying job to become a volunteer catechist. During that time, former Archbishop Jaime Cardinal Sin, these two know each other, then she was allowed practice catechism during Saturday. That was her catechism background. Because of the Legion of Mary, maybe that's their policy that every Saturday she's allowed to practice catechism. That's it. She has one goal. she asked herself, what is the will of God? That is how she described herself as a Filipino catechist. A lot of you will be surprised because as a saint, you cannot be a saint without when did she die. This one is, her cause of death is ovarian cancer. So she was struggling her health status. She died on October 17, 2011 in Taguig City, Metro Manila at age 75. By the way, her birth, she was born on July 4, 1936. This is in Barangay Hagonoy, Taguig. It was not city that time during her birth. So that's it. I hope that this necrological video will give at least a little attention, and this is the best that I could make this kind of video. Actually, many suggest that can I make this video, so I said okay, yes. I respect their religion because I am not a Catholic, I am a Protestant, but although I came from Catholic school in high school and I also finished my college a Catholic school also, so I respect their religion. Mine is only to give details as a necrologist practitioner. Thank you so much for listening. Good morning.